This is the solution to quiz 7. Okay. So, part A, let's sketch. Region R. Okay. Well, this is simple enough to understand. So this is a vertical line. X is 6 is also a vertical line. Y is 0, well, that's the x-axis, and that's a horizontal line. And then this is a square root function. So it's going to look like, if this is the xy-axis, then somewhere in the back here, so back here at 433 divided by 2, at negative 200-ish, we'll have a function. It has its 0 back here, and then it's a square root looking function. Okay, so all those need to be combined. Okay, so then, again, this is just a sketch, not really to scale. So then at x is 3, and at x is 6, that this horizontal line is y is 0, and then this blue graph is y is square root, so square root 2x plus 433. The region in question is this. Okay, then for part B, the request in the end is to rotate that shaded region around the x-axis. Okay, so it will look like this. That, and then it will be rotated, so I'll try and draw it in perspective a little bit. So we'd be able to see that, which means we'd be able to see this, but not this one. Okay, a solid object, kind of like a solid lampshade looking thing. Okay, then C. Again, to remind you, the formula for the volume of a surface of revolution looks like the integral from A to B of pi times the radius squared class we called that f of x. So pi times the radius squared dx. And just to remind you, since it's been a little bit, to remind you, this is the radius r, and this is the height of an infinitesimal cylinder, GHT. And this integral is summing up the formula for infinitely many infinitesimal cylinders, the volume of that, so pi r squared h. Just to remind you of the where that formula comes from. So in this particular exercise, this amounts to the integral from 3 to 6 of pi, and then square root 2x plus 433 squared dx. And we'd love to use the fundamental theorem, so I'll see if I can simplify this. In the first place, pi can come out. So pi integral 3 to 6, and then the square root and the square cancel, and we get 2x plus 433 dx, and then, okay, that's just a polynomial. So that's pi, and then the antiderivative of 2x is x squared, and the antiderivative of 433 is 433x, and then we can evaluate this from 3 to 6. Keeping the pi factored out and evaluating that. So that'd be 6 squared plus 433 times 6. So that's 2, 6, 3, 4. And then minus 3 squared times 433 times 3 is 1308. And then 2634 minus 1308 is, 1326. Okay, so that's the answer to part one. Part two, question two, find the average value. Okay, to remind you, the formula for average value looks like 1 over b minus a integral a to b f of x dx. Okay, and then just as a reminder, that's the formula, but it comes from, in the end, the formula for discrete average that looks like 1 over n times the sum from I is 1 to n of ai. So these two formulas are intimately related. So this is the discrete average. And this is continuous. Continuous average. So that's the one that we're using. So in this particular exercise, the interval is 2 to 6, so that will be 1 over 6 minus 2 integral 2 to 6, and then that thing, 3x squared plus 2x minus 47 dx, okay, well, 1 over 6 minus 2, that's 1 over 4, and then the antiderivative of that would be x cubed, and then plus x squared, minus 47, and then we're going to evaluate this from 2 to 6, okay, so I'll keep the 1/4 factored out, and then plug in 6 for all that, 6 cubed plus 6 squared minus 47, that should be, that should be 47x, careful here, 47x, and then 2 to 6, okay, so minus 47 times 6, so that's negative 30, and then minus, now plug in 2, so that'd be 2 cubed plus 2 squared minus 47 times 2, so that's minus negative 82. So negative 30 and then plus 82, since the things cancel, this is 52. So 52 over 4 is 13. And it was a little bit of a joke because we have 13 and we also have 26. Okay, and then finally, okay, again, the average value is given by the formula integral, and since we're using letter A here, I'll write 1 over t minus s, and then integral s to t, f of x dx. Normally, we call those a and b, but because we've got a there, I didn't want to confuse the matter. So that's the average value. So specifically, in this exercise, the average value is going to be 1 over 3 minus 0, integral 0 to 3, and then ax squared plus 2 dx. So this is the average value, and this will be a function of parameter A. Okay, and we want the A which gives value 2018. Okay. So let's evaluate this. So that's a third. 1 over 3 minus 0 is a third. And then the antiderivative of that is what? A x cubed over 3, and then plus 2x, and then we're going to evaluate this from 0 to 3. Okay, so I'll keep the third factored out, and plugging in 3, we get what? So 27 over 3 is 9, so we get 9a, and then plus, plugging in 3, we get 6, and then minus plugging in 0, we get all zeros. So then that would be 1/3 times 9a plus 6, and then distributing the third in, that would be 3a plus 2. So that's what I meant. So the average is a function of parameter a, and now we want to solve this thing equal to 2018, which is what I meant by the green statement. So 3a plus 2 equal 2018. Okay, so then 3a is 2016. So 2016 over 3 is 672. So that's the answer to the question.